healthcare is one of the few industries that are 20 years behind every other industry using technology to improve quality.
There's just reams of paper that is almost impossible to analyze.
There is so much work to be done in healthcare. It is in dire need of a leap in the way it functions.
We have well-intentioned physicians, well-intentioned hospitals, but we have a poorly designed system.
Patients had to deliver this data manually over and over and over to other people in the healthcare system.
I got interested in improvement because I nearly took the life of a 7-year-old child. I gave that child a 10 times overdose of the drug scopolamine. She survived my care that night, but just barely. And it made me start thinking about the design of care when that order was hand transcribed 6 times before it reached me as the nurse, when it can be death by decimal point. I began to look at the design of systems and say, why is it structured this way? It's not about incompetence, it's not about commitment. This was about system design, so I got interested in improvement.
These beacon communities from Maine to Hawaii are an amazing opportunity using health information technology for some really dramatic change.
This is a program about finding ways of using IT to improve patient care. We want to see that spill over into the rest of the country.
Our goal for this is really to ensure that we can generate a community of collaborating partners who can learn from each other about what is working, what isn't working, so that we can really deliver health care more efficiently.
That saves the system in so many ways. It saves the patient if they have a copay. It saves the employer from having their employee not being at work because they're having a duplicative test. It saves our payer system for paying for something that's already happened.
The technology lets information flow back to the personal physician in the context of a patient-centered medical home.
Medical home is really the essence that you establish a center of coordination and care for a patient.
A lot of this project is all about education because consumers need to be empowered, they need to be engaged, they need to care about their own care.
Our hope is that we'll be able to encourage better lifestyle choices and introduce more prevention.
It's really going to help the patients make a better decision because they're getting better information.
Whether the person received an eye exam here or a foot exam there or had their lab tests done somewhere else, all that information is available to whoever needs it for that patient's treatment.
We have experts in intensive care medicine in a central place that are monitoring patients in their intensive care rooms at the smaller hospitals where they don't have 24-hour-a-day intensivists available.
If you end up in an emergency room and you're unconscious, your electronic medical record becomes your voice. That could literally save your life.
I've seen cases where patients have come in late with a heart attack. They end up not doing well because it took too long to get them the care that they needed. There's a lot of things that technology can do that shorten that time. We can now transmit wirelessly from the field to the hospital so the cardiologist can get ready even before the patient arrives at the hospital.
The technological part is actually the easiest part. The hardest part is saying, are we willing to share? Are we willing to play in the same sandbox? It's not dangerous to share information. There's actually benefit for all of us.
There are definitely safeguards that ensure that privacy is maintained. The softwares actually have the capacity to actually show the fingerprints of who signed on and who looked at the chart. You can't do that with a paper chart. A paper chart is lying around in the hallway. You just grab it, open it, look at it, and put it right back.
We want to make a real impact on healthcare quality and safety and efficiency across the country.
People's idea of healthcare has to shift from healthcare as treating disease to healthcare as taking care of health.
At this moment in history, I think we have all the forces aligned to make this happen quickly.
We can learn from others, and I think others can learn from us. I think every one of our communities have something to offer, and I think that's the whole premise behind the Beacon, is to give the rest of the nation something to look at.